Clickbait alert. You caught me red-handed. I told a white lie when I said that you must know these colour idioms. The truth is, these idioms will definitely help you in conversational English. Now, I know that this video is a bit out of the blue, but you now have a golden opportunity to learn all about colour idioms with me. So by the end of this lesson, you'll know 20 colour idioms, and if I ever test you, which I might, you'll pass with flying colours. Hello everyone, Anna here from EnglishLikeANative.com. Today's lesson is sponsored by Lingoda. Now, if you're new here and learning English, please click subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any future lessons or live classes. Right, let's get cracking. To catch someone red-handed is to discover someone in the act of doing something wrong. For example, if the police found a robber still holding the bag that he has stolen, you could say, "They caught him red-handed." Or if a mother walked into the kitchen at night to find her son with chocolate cake all over his face, you might say, "Aha, I've caught you red-handed." Grey area. A grey area is an ill-defined, unclear situation, which does not have an obvious answer or outcome. It's not black or white. That's another idiom, meaning it's not clear. It's a grey area. For example, if I use a clip from a movie in this video to illustrate an educational point, is that copyright infringement? It's not clear. It's a bit of a grey area. To give the green light. This means to give permission for someone to do something or for something to happen. For example, a parent could give the green light for their child to start a new club or to go on a school trip. Go on, sonny! In the red. If a person or a company is in the red, that means they've spent more money than they have and now they owe money to the bank. I can't sleep at night, not now that we're in the red. Once in a blue moon. If something happens once in a blue moon, it happens very rarely. For example, we go on holiday once in a blue moon. It doesn't mean never, it just means not often. Out of the blue. If something happens out of the blue, then it is completely unexpected. For example, my brother arrived out of the blue. So his brother was completely unexpected. Red tape. Red tape refers to rules or boundaries that prevent or slow down something you're trying to achieve. For example, it took me ages to get a working visa because of all the red tape. Rose-tinted glasses. To look at something through rose-tinted glasses means to think of it with a positive bias. Perhaps only seeing or paying attention to the good things. For example, I have lots of fond memories of school. I can't remember the bad parts. I suppose I look back at it through rose-tinted glasses. To show one's true colours. To show one's true colours means to reveal the kind of person you really are. This could be used in a positive way. For example, Nicole was so patient with the children. She really showed her true colours. Or in a negative way. For example, I can't believe Nicole betrayed you. She has really shown her true colours. Golden opportunity. This is an excellent chance to do something that is likely to be successful or rewarding. For example, going to Oxford University is a golden opportunity, or being invited to go to a place you've always wanted to go to is a golden opportunity. Now, Lingoda are offering a golden opportunity. This is your last chance to join their upcoming sprint to improve your speaking skills and confidence in just 3 months and get 50% cash back. Lingoda sprint classes are accessible 24/7. You can learn anytime and anywhere, even in the evenings or at the weekends or whenever is most convenient to your lifestyle. The more intensive super sprint has sold out, but there are still seats available for the sprint program, which consists of 15 classes per month, and it gives you 50% cash back if you attend all of your classes. Now, I've been working with Lingoda for over 3 years, and I can tell you that joining an intensive learning program like this is a great way to finally speak confidently in any situation. More than 40,000 people have participated in the previous Lingoda sprints, and I'm always thrilled to hear their success stories. Lingoda is the number one trusted European language school, offering very affordable prices. So even if you don't manage to attend all of your classes, you'll end up paying from 10 euros for a small group class with a maximum of 5 students. Now, you can join the sprint in English, German, French, Spanish, and Business English. There is no deposit needed. You just pay for your first month directly. And if you use the code, then you'll get 10 euros off your first month's tuition. The sprint starts on the 28th of April and you can sign up until the 23rd. Remember, if you attend 15 classes a month for 3 months, you get 50% cash back. As with anything, always check all the rules carefully before signing up. Don't forget, the sign-up window closes in just 1 week, so don't miss out. Sign up for the sprint today by clicking on the link below. Now back to the lesson. A white lie. A white lie is a lie about a small or unimportant matter that someone tells to avoid hurting another person. For example, it was a bit of a white lie. I told her I couldn't go to her party, but really, I just didn't want to. To pass with flying colours. To pass something with flying colours means to do it very successfully. For example, if you get top marks in an exam, you could say you've passed with flying colours. See red. To see red means to become very angry. For example, when I realised he'd been lying, I saw red. Blue colour. This phrase refers to the collar on a labourer's uniform and is typically used to refer to people who work in manual labour such as agriculture, manufacturing, and construction. In context, you could say he's got a new blue collar job as an electrician. White collar. This refers to an office worker or someone whose profession does not require manual labour. In context, you could say, he's got a new white-collar job as a lawyer. A red flag. A red flag is a sign of a problem which requires attention. For example, the fact that no one seemed to enjoy working there was a red flag. This means that it's a sign that should be paid attention to. You probably won't enjoy working somewhere if everyone who works there doesn't enjoy their job. Red letter day. A red letter day is a special or memorable occasion. For example, when Francesca returns from her 2-year trip, it'll be a red letter day. Although I will just add that red letter day is probably now falling out of fashion, as we don't really send letters anymore. Next, to paint the town red. This means to party or celebrate in a rowdy or wild manner, particularly in a public place such as a nightclub or bar. You could say, for my birthday, we'll paint the town red, which just means we'll party. Next, to roll out the red carpet. This means to welcome someone with special treatment. For example, oh, when she gets home from the hospital, we'll roll out the red carpet. Meaning we'll take extra good care of her. This refers to the red carpet that celebrities and VIPs walk on to get to award ceremonies or premieres. It indicates a mark of respect and good care. Bringing me on to my next one, red carpet treatment. Along the same lines as the last one, but it's not about only welcoming someone when they first arrive somewhere. To give someone the red carpet treatment is to treat them as if they are special and important. For example, at this hotel, we give all of our guests the red carpet treatment. So there we have 20 colour idioms which we use conversationally in the English language. Now here's a challenge to test your new knowledge. How many of these idioms can you fit into one paragraph? Give it a try and post your paragraph in the comments. If you'd like to learn 10 more colour idioms which can be used to describe people, then see the link in the description below. Until next time, take care and goodbye.